The Florida grasshopper sparrow is a bird that's resident to Florida. Right now we're conducting a 3-year research project to try to figure out what some of the causes of decline are. So there are a lot of hypotheses about why the sparrow population might be declining. One of the predominant things is loss of habitat. Three Lakes Wildlife Management Area currently has the largest population. Ready? When we're trying to capture an unbanded bird, we usually arrive at the site before dawn. We locate the bird if it's singing. We approach the bird, usually within 50 meters. We set up a mist net that's set into the ground with poles, and then we use Floridanus or Pratensis long song recording to draw the bird closer to the net. Is he in?
Yeah.
We remove the bird from the net carefully and take it a little ways away where we have all of our banding supplies. It's beauty. We mark the birds with color bands so that we'll be able to identify them as individuals later. We measure the bill, the depth, the length of the bill, the tarsus, the wing length. We check the bird for ectoparasites. We also collect blood samples for DNA analysis. And we try to process the birds as quickly as possible to reduce the amount of handling stress. As soon as we're done taking all those measurements, we release the bird at the original site.
That way.
Florida grasshopper sparrows have very low nest success. It may be only 1 in 3 nests are successful. Okay, when we're looking for nests, what we try to do is find the female that's associated with the territory. Unfortunately, we haven't been able to find very many females. We don't know if that's because there aren't very many females left in the population or if it just has to do with how cryptic they are. Another method that we use for nest searching is just systematic walking through a bird's territory, where we carefully walk, scanning the ground for signs of a nest. Their nests are very hard to find. They're constructed out of dead grass and they're built with a dome. So even if you're looking down on the nest, you can't actually see any eggs or any indication that it is a nest. If this was an active nest, I would not be bringing anyone here to see it because it's a very sensitive thing. If and when we do find nests, we are very careful to stay in the area only for a very short time. We usually mark the nest location with a GPS unit and place a few flags near the nest, not right on the nest, but just near it. And then we back away as soon as possible to let the birds return and also avoid leaving our scent in the area that could attract mammal predators. The reason that this bird is on the brink of extinction primarily has to do with the fact that so little Florida dry prairie exists. The whole prairie ecosystem is maintained by fire. And historically, this fire would have been created after lightning strikes. So the wildlife managers here, Steve Glass and Tina Hannon, burn the prairie in 2-year rotations to keep the habitat appropriate for grasshopper sparrows. Controlled burning is really important for the sparrow. It's probably one of the most important things that can be done to preserve the bird, is to maintain regular burning cycles in the prairie.